Greetings and salutations, MegaWizard79 here with another episode of Dark Souls. So, in our last episode, we braved the bastards that are the archers of Anor Londo, the infamous dynamic duo of Dark Souls. I hate those guys so much. Honestly, things might have gone more smoother if it wasn't for that blasted invader screwing up everything. Oh well, I should have known better. Alright, well, may as well just talk to Solaire right now. Just so you guys know, if you want to keep Solaire alive until the end of the game, you can choose not to talk to him here, and if you don't, he just stays here. Because, you see, the thing about, Dark Souls NPCs in this iteration, not so much in future iterations, but in this iteration, if you don't talk to him, he ain't budging. He will literally stay here and 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 stay here for all of eternity. But yeah, but since I am going to save him, rest assured, I'm going to do it the annoying way by gathering up 30 humanity and then giving them to Quelag's sister. To do that, though, I have to be part of the Covenant, which I will join later on. But yeah, I am going to save him, and I'm going to have him fight alongside me against Lord Gwyn at the end of the game. That's going to be fun, so stay tuned to that. But anyway, let's get it chatting, shall we?
Oh, there you are. You've been quiet these days. Smooth summoning out there. Anytime you see my brilliantly shining signature, do not hesitate to call upon me. You've left me with quite an impression. I would relish a chance to assist you.
All right.
You really are fond of chatting with me, aren't you? If I didn't know better, I'd think you had feelings for me. Oh no, dear me, pretend you didn't hear that.
What a nice guy. Let me just double check and make sure that's all his dialogue. I'm pretty sure that's all he says, though.
You really are, if I don't know.
Yep, that's all he says. Alright, now then. The only enemy type you'll be facing from this point onward is pretty much, Silver Knights. There are three other enemy types here, but for the most part, the majority of the enemies you'll be facing are Silver Knights, and they come in two flavors. They come in spear guys, and they come in sword guys. Pretty much all of them have Dragon Slayer bows, so yeah. It's usually the sword guys, though, that have them, but I think they all technically have them. Alright, anyway. Now, technically speaking, I shouldn't be using this weapon against him, because Silver Knight armor is very resistant to lightning, but as you saw, I guess me upgrading this to +4 kind of says, screw your resistances. Case in point. Now these guys are actually the easiest to kill. Now the only thing they drop is their respective weapons. Sword guys drop swords. Spear guys drop spears. Archers drop swords or bows. The bow is a very rare drop. Actually, no, you don't have to get the bow to drop. The bow you can... They all have a chance of dropping giant Dragon Slayer arrows, and they each have the chance of dropping their respective weapons, and they all have a chance of dropping their spear. Shield. Alright. 3 sunlight medals. Yay. That brings me to a total of 6. Alright. I'm not gonna kindle that bonfire. It's not a particularly useful one. Alright, now then, there'll be one more silver knight. Yep, there he is. This one's a sword. Now, all their attacks are pretty much 3-hit combos. Once he does that, he's completely wide open. Pretty simple. This is actually a very good place to farm souls. Alright. Now, that sound you're hearing, your ears do not deceive you. That's a Titanite demon. And he's placed in a very unfair location. Now, the purpose of this is to give you, is to tell you that there's actually, a room here. But when you enter here, there's this big wall here. But there's clearly a room over there. I saw it. There's a window. Is it just a trick of the developers? No. Boom. Of course, that was one of the most obvious secret doors that you'll probably ever come in contact with. Alright, so, down here, you will receive the most sought-after armor, weapon, and shield in the entire game. As you can see, that one's a mimic, so I'll leave that one alone for now. Dragon Tooth. Havel's Great Shield. Havel's Helm. Havel's Armor. Havel's Gauntlets. Havel's Leggings. And with that, the Havel set is now complete. Look at that. Just look at that. Look at those numbers. Just look at those numbers. There it is. 50 strength. Yeah. Still, look at that. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yep, Havel Shield is just slightly worse in regards to fire damage than the... Yep. Havel Shield... Yep. Obviously, the Dragon Crest Shield has the best because it's intended to be the one with the highest defense. But the Black Iron one actually is the absolute best because it has 90. But yeah, see? Just look at that. Like, this is the most kick-ass magic defense shield in the entire game. It kicks the hell out of the Crest Shield, which is intended to be the strongest, well, at least in terms of medium shield, anyway. But yeah. And then, of course, the Dragon Tooth. One of the most heaviest, if not the most heaviest, weapon in the entire game. I think the only thing heavier than that is Smough's hammer. Just look at this. Look at... Oop. There we go. Look at that. Just look at that. And yeah. Oh my god, can I? Am I doing the... I can do the medium roll? In a full Havel set? No way. Hang on. Or is that the fat roll? I can't... No, I don't think that's the fat roll. Let me see. Yeah, I think that's the fat roll. Yeah, that was the fat roll. I thought that was the medium roll. But still... But yeah, this thing is sick. Even two-handing it, I can't really use it, but... it's an incredibly powerful weapon with an insane amount of durability. Now, something to note. As you can see, this thing is covered in chains and stuff. In later iterations, the chains are gone. Like, if I recall correctly, I don't even think the chains on his armor are even there anymore. But yeah, like, for some reason, they remove the chains from the shield, and they just make it a straight-up, just, you know, just the shield without the chains. But yeah, just like a nice little fun fact for you guys to notice. Alright, let's go back to my preferred set. Alright, now... put that on. Now, the reason I have that is so that, if at any point I feel like the, you know, like if the Hallberg isn't doing enough damage, I can switch over to this, and I can do this. Look at that damage. 502. Or sorry, 502. Not 502. That's incorrect. Oh yeah, that reminds me. Alright. Get rid of those. Alright, now as I've stated before, this is a mimic. Goodbye. Look at that. Alright. Did I get it? No. Oh well. I mean, I am guaranteed to get it. I really don't need to farm for it, but it's nice to get it earlier rather than later. Anyway, so the occult club, it's just a regular old club. It just has the occult infusion, which what it does is it gives it magic damage. And the added bonus is that if I went and used this weapon against Gwendolyn, it would have advantage against him because these weapons are designed to, well, I mean the occult infusion. The occult infusion is designed to kill gods. That's the whole point of it. Like anything relatively divine, it's meant to essentially screw with. Like that's the whole point of it. All right, but yep, that's the whole point of this room. Alright, now let's get on out of here. See, what's my weight? Yeah. Oh, well, whatever. It doesn't really matter. I mean, the Silver Knights are fast, but as long as you have your wits about you, they won't really do much to you. I just want to get their shield, sword, and spear. So I'm just going to wear that ring for a while. Let me see. I'll live with the fat roll. Alright, so this room over here. This is a trap. Or, no, actually, no, there's really no purpose to this room at all. The only reason is just to show off, the trophy room, if you will. Yeah. Look at all of these. Exactly the same dragon heads just mounted on these walls. But, yeah. Essentially, that's, supposed to be Ornstein's trophy room. Because Ornstein is, Alright. Now, bring him out here. Because fighting him in that, it's just a bad idea. Yeah, he has insane stability with that. There we go. I really want the spear. The spear is actually... Their spear is actually really cool. Now, something you need to know about Silver Knight weapons. They upgrade with Twinkling Titanite. So, they're not the simplest of things to upgrade. But they are very powerful. Alright. Now, this is a mimic. And that's a mimic. They're both mimics. Oh, and as you saw, there's a Silver Knight down there with a, Dragon Slayer bow. Once you get close enough to him, though, he pulls out a sword and spear. A sword and shield. Alright. Nope. That was close. Alright, what'd you drop for me? Right, the gold coin. He drops a gold coin, the other guy drops a silver coin. Oh, right. Sorry, there are silver knights behind this door over here, so they're, you know, by me walking close to it, they're aware of me, but they can't get out of there. Alright. Here we go. Yes! I got it. I got it. Alright. This helmet is heavy. It's 10 units. Heavier than Havel's helm. Has okay resistances. It has no poison resistance, no curse resistance. Its bleed thing is sucks. It has really nice poise. Has good poise, not that much bleed, terrible poison, horrible curse, good slash, thrust, and physical defense, terrible everywhere else, but the beauty about this thing is that it not only, yes, I can do it, yeah, I'm gonna wear this for a while, now, there are negative sides to this thing. Like, normally you don't want to wear this when you're exploring a zone like I am. For the simple fact that, as you can see, my health is slowly ticking away. The reason for that is this helmet has... It essentially has a status effect on it, which is cursing me. So what it's doing is that it's literally leeching my health away. Boom. So yeah, so it's leeching my health away. Nah, I didn't want Dragon Slayer arrows. Anyway, but yeah, but it's slowly leeching my health away by like 10... It's like a I think it's like a certain percentage. Oops. Let me see, I think it says like... Yeah, wearing this slightly raises soul absorption and item discovery, but also affects its wearer with the Curse of the Branded. So yeah, the Curse of the Branded, as you can see, it leeches your health away. So you can't wear this forever. Even though you probably wish you could. But yeah, it raises item discovery and whatnot. It's a really cool item. It's really useful if you want to farm. Because while it doesn't stack... while it does not stack with the Covetous Gold Serpent Ring, I think it does stack with the Silver Serpent Ring. So, well, I mean, we just got it, right? Okay, that, what? Why would they have the same one? Poser. But yeah. That's Guinevere right there. Alright, so watch out when you open this door. See? There's a silver knight right there. He'll usually get a cheap shot on you. Yeah, see. Ow. Just lead him out of that room. Come on. Because he has like too many advantages in that room. There we go. His 3-hit combo was no match for my 2-hit. Anyway. Now that other door over there that I ignored, you can't open it from this side. Now, don't be fooled. There are just because that's probably like the only one I've ever captured on camera, so to speak. There are tons of doors in this game that say cannot be opened from this side. I just know where they are, so I've been avoiding them because there's no point. That and also you know. All right. So, that guy over there won't attack you right away. He'll only attack you once you get close to him. This guy's the annoying one. You gotta get rid of him first. There we go. Alright. Now, before we proceed down that way, we're gonna go this way. because this way will lead us into that room that we couldn't get into before. Alright. Oh, nice. So that's the... That move they just... That move right there, that was the, when he puts his shield over his sword like that, you can't... I don't think you can parry that attack. I think that's their unparryable attack. I don't even think you can block it effectively. Onion Knight! So, it's come to my attention that apparently, this open window here, it's supposed to imply that, he climbed up this way. Which is, quite a feat. Considering that he's wearing that bloated armor. I mean, I don't think he's actually that big. That's just how his armor is designed, because the whole point of his armor is that it's meant to deflect weapons. Because, you see, the thing you need to understand about weapons, specifically things like swords and axes, is that edge alignment is key. Edge alignment is the difference between a dismemberment and a shallow cut. The disparity is that huge. So yeah, so that armor right there pretty much says fuck your edge alignment, flat out. Pardon my French, but yeah, pretty. So basically, you know, as silly as it looks, it is actually incredibly effective, and you know, it might have actually caught on back in the medieval era if they could have constructed armor like that. The issue with armor like this is that it's kind of hard to make because, I mean, as you can see, the shape and stuff, it's kind of awkward. So you would first need to basically, you would essentially need to, it would be a lot of work. Like, you would have to, because the issue is like, you know, this isn't like making a dress. You can't just like put it over a mannequin and then, you know, get the dress to basically be that, to contour to that form. With this, you have to hammer it into these shapes. So, yeah. Whoever made this armor, miles ahead of their time, and a masterful craftsman, but my god, he must have been on the cups of death afterward. It's really that, like, making armor is that, time-consuming. Anyway, let's talk to him, shall we?
Whatever can be done. Ah, you again. Let me guess. Were you repelled by the Silver Knight? Ah, don't be ashamed. It is the fate of vanguards like you and I. I'll think of something. We can overcome this together.
So he's talking about that room over there. There's like five knights in there, in one room.
This is quite a fix. We'll need another three, no, maybe five bodies. Quite a fix indeed.
So, like always, just go in there and solve the problem for him. So yeah, there's one of them. Now, if you're lucky, you can get him to get out of that room. Ow. And bring him up the stairs. And take him into the nice and open courtyard where his attacks count for shit. Look at... I shouldn't be able to do this to him with lightning. I really should not be able to do that to him. His armor is literally supposed to mean... His armor literally is like, screw lightning. Flat out. It's supposed to be resistant to it. Alright, so... Oh, sorry, I miscounted. There's only three in here. Right, because I counted the two up there. Never mind. Oh, crud, I aggroed both of them. Bad, bad me. Whatever. Alright, here comes one of them. Come on. And that's why I call him Twinkle Toes. I love that attack of theirs. Oh no. Boom. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you clean house. Okay. Now, I don't know if there's actually a point to opening this door. I don't know if he actually needs it to be open to get out, but I'm just gonna open it anyway. So a lot of people believe that these paintings right here are actually the concept art for the game. That being said, though, this concept art is real. I really like that that drawn to scale right there. I mean, look at that little tiny guy compared to that guy. But yeah, but that guy... oh, that's right. I forgot. There's a chest in here. Yep. That's also why you want to come in here, to get the chest. And I think that's it. Yep. So, but yeah, the thing about that one, though, is that sentinel is real. There's two of them. They're right before the doors to Ornstein and Smo. And they're absolute bastards because they can cast miracles. And they can heal themselves. Like, you know, like they really needed it.
Oh ho! What's on your mind, friend? Wait. You defeated those monsters? Fantastic. I'm saved. This knight of Katarina hereby commends you. Take this as a token of my gratitude.
Tiny Beings Ring. It's one of the rings that you could have gotten as your gift at the beginning of the game. It just raises your HP by a tiny amount, and I mean a tiny amount. It's not worth the metal it's made from.
But be warned, gallantry entails great risks. Next time, give me a chance to come up with a plan.
It's funny coming from him, considering that he's always flying by the seat of his pants.
But be warned, next.
All right, that's all of that. All right. So, now that that's taken care of. Alright, let's head this way. Now, there is something to be said about this spiral staircase. Now, let's see. So, alright, so, the thing about this spiral, as you can see, it's a dual spiral staircase. Like, there's actually a staircase, yeah, like, as you can see, like, see? There's another staircase right there. That's actually where we started, from. Like, you know, like, that, that's where we came from. Over there, that's Solaire's bonfire. But yeah, so the thing about this staircase is, if you you know, if you're up there, on that part of the staircase, and if you time your jump just right, you can leap over that handrail and land right here and skip all of this. Because Ornstein and Smo are right there. Like, that hallway leads straight to their boss chamber. So yeah. So, if you don't want to, I mean, here. I'll show you. Let's see. Alright, so. Now, it's recommended that you should be very light for this jump, because you need, you need some decent, you need some decent, voltage, if you will. Yes, I know, that's not a real word. Anyway, so yeah, so I'm just gonna get completely naked. I mean, to be honest, I'll just get rid of my weapon, too. Alright, so. Just go down here. Alright, so see, that's the way we want to end up. So what you do is you take a running start, hug the wall. Eh, sorry, it's... Like I said, it's a very tricky jump, but it is possible. because... Alright. Yeah, see? You gotta, like, aim your jump from, like, up here. So close. That would have been my death. Ow. But yeah, see? It's possible. It is 100% possible. You can do it. Let's try one more time. At all. Yeah, like, as you can see, though, I am doing it. I'm just getting the location I want to jump to off. Alright. So, where I want to jump is right there. There we go. Boom. And that's all there is to it. It takes a few tries, but you can do it. Alright, now then. That's where the Titanite Demon is. But before we go there, we want to go here. Now, the reason you want to basically jump off there and stuff is because when you jump off there, you gain access to this room, which... Well... Ah. Alright. Anyway. Ow. Oh no. No. That always will happen. Anyway, I was, yeah. Alright, no, he shouldn't. I hope he doesn't. Alright, that's where I want to be. Oh no. That was close. Anyway. Alright. So, once again. Ah, I didn't get the jump running start right. Anyway. Alright. And there you go. As I was saying, the reason you want to come up here, I mean, the reason you want to be here, alright, so that guy will always just come straight at you from all the way over there. So what you want to do is drag him all the way up here where you have much more room, because he's an asshole and he just loves cock blocking. There we go. Now then. Now that one down there, his aggro range is much, much, much smaller. You have to essentially be touching him for him to attack you. Alright, so. If that guy hadn't chased me up the stairs, you would have realized that this is the room right across from Havel's secret little weapon chamber, if you will. Alright, yeah, see? You gotta get, like, Yeah, like right up in his face. Like right up in his face. And your reward? My second favorite armor set in the entire game. The Silver Knight armor set. It's amazing. Again, fairly heavy. Weighing at, yeah. That weighs... Actually, it's much lighter than the armor I was wearing. Slightly better, too, though it doesn't have as many good resistances. Yeah, see? Look at that lightning defense. That's 34 lightning defense. This thing is meant to protect you against lightning. But yeah, this is a really cool armor set. Let me see. Alright, it has much better physical defenses, so I'm just gonna wear this right now while I go and deal with this nuisance. Alright, so this guy. So the annoying thing about this guy, it's mostly that. I'm not really dealing that much damage to him, unfortunately. Mostly because he just... And he killed me. I hate this guy so much. But you kind of want to kill him. Mostly because I think this one gives you... Alright. But yeah, I'm not dealing that much damage with this thing, so... Alright. It's time we, bust out the big boy. I love this thing! Make Swiss ch- There. But yeah, this thing makes mincemeat of Silver Knights. It's a beautiful thing. But yeah, like I said, that guy's not gonna bother you. You have to literally get in his face. He just stands there and watches you kill his buddies. Anyway. Alright, so. Yeah, unfortunately, it's like right there. Oh, why did I jump into that? Let's try it again. Right. Oh, come on. Damn it, he killed me. It's okay. It's fine. We can do this. We will beat him. Alright. Yeah, when they have their shield up, you can't pancake them. But when they don't have their shield up, you can. I traded with them. That was bad. Oh, well, whatever. I gotta be careful. I don't wanna... I'd rather not lose those souls. Eh, no spear. Alright, this time I'm gonna do the smart thing. Let me check something. No, not that one. Alright, yeah, that's what I thought. But... Alright. Since I had that ring on when I did it, it should last longer now. Alright, just wanted to make sure. Oh no. I didn't even know he could do that. That's a new attack for me. Damn it. I'm really sorry for this. It's just that guy is so annoying to fight in that room. There we go. I'm lucky I might get... Oh, well. I love the fact that a single backstab destroys them. It feels great. Alright. Try this again. Oh gosh. You know what? Forget it. He's not worth it. I'll do it another time. I've wasted enough time as it is, and I have a few more things that I do want to show you before I leave. Now then, there they are, those bastards. Now, my preferred method to dealing with these guys is actually to poison them, just flat out. Because these guys are the worst, and what really sucks is that there's a Silver Knight up there who has, he's like over there on the left. Ow. Screw you. Yeah, see? Yep, and here comes the other one. No. Also, don't be fooled. They can follow you up here. Get out of my... Of course you would. Yeah, see? They can follow you up here for a fair distance. Anyway, now... Alright, now... Okay, there's one thing I have to do... Before I, go down... Before I go that way. For this segment, I'm not gonna fight them. I'm just gonna put this on. Yeah, I'm still kinda heavy. Well, whatever. Anyway. Alright. Now, he can see me. Doesn't really matter. Yeah, see? They're really slow. Alright. There we go. Voila. The big gate's open. Alright. Like I said, that guy's like really sick. Oh my gosh. I forget that they can just bomb rush you. I really hate those guys. They suck. Anyway, now the significance of doing that is, in the event that you screw up this platforming over here, you don't have to go all the way around or use a homeward bone to get back. I'm just gonna put this armor back on. Alright. Alright. Eh. I just like the way this weapon looks. I mean, don't get me wrong, the Zweihänder is still my one true love, but oh boy, I love this weapon. It looks so cool. Alright, so we just go down this way. Take this corner. Jump right in here. And there you go. Dragon Slayer, Great Bow, and an arrow. I think it was only one. Alright. Now, the best way to avoid dying from this wall, well, for one, heal up. Two. Oh. Oh, gosh. You are a bastard, you know that? Ugh, I hate him. Anyway, now, there's another door over here that you want to open. So, as you can see, if you screw up that jump and you land on that side, you won't be able to get back in here because there's a door right there that is, you know, that was locked. Alright, so, there's only this guy here, so you don't need to worry. Ow. One. Yep, there he goes. I take it back. There was another guy. Wow. Okay. And you. Alright. This should be a chunk. Yep. Alright. And then there's one more over there. And there's the guy I wanted to show off. My favorite blacksmith in the entire franchise. And to you. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the giant blacksmith. Like, that's literally his name, he's a giant blacksmith. Anyway, now, there's a chest over here most people miss. Hang on, just really hard to, there we go. Voila, the hawk ring. This will increase the, range of your bows significantly, so it makes the Black Bow of Ferris disgusting. Anyway, now, so that's pretty much it for the level. This completes it. The last thing that's just needs to do is just kill the boss, which we will do in the next episode, obviously. It's a pity. I wanted to finish this off with talking to him and killing that Titanite demon, but eh. One out of two isn't bad.
Who are you? Forge your weapons.
Now he's a master of words. So, this guy. He is your endgame blacksmith. He is the one you bring your boss souls to. For he can modify them into super cool stuff. Obviously, I can't. Yeah. Like, see? Like, right here. Like, if I had the soul of Gwendolyn, I could make the tin banishment catalyst. The tin dark moon catalyst. That's what I meant to say. If I had the soul of Manus, I can make it the Manus catalyst. If I had the soul of Cinder, I can make the great lord of, the great lord great sword with my Zweihänder. I can make the abyss great sword with the soul of Artorias. And that's pretty much it, because those are the only weapons that I these are the only weapons I could use to make souls out of. I can make a lightning's Zweihänder. Oh yeah, I was wrong. My apologies, it does remove the scaling. Oopsie. It's still a powerful weapon, though. I remember I turned that into a lightning's Zweihänder, and oh boy, I never looked back. Yeah, and then same old, he can just upgrade your weapons and whatnot. So, what the ember that you bring to him is the Crystal Ember, which you get within the Duke's Archive, which you don't get until pretty much the end of the whole zone. But here is where he shines. Large Titanite Shard, Green Titanite Shard, Twinkling Titanite Shard. Yep. This is the reason you come to him. And as you can see, you can buy the Giant's Halberd or Giant Shield, but I was lucky enough to get it off the enemies. So, he also sells the Moonlight Arrows, which are very powerful. Dragon's Lair Arrows. He pretty much sells all the best arrows in the game. And then he sells this, the Giant Armor Set, which specifically states in his, yep, right here, impede stamina recovery. It's extremely heavy for humans because it wasn't meant for us. But it's a really cool armor set. It pretty much blocks a lot of stuff. The only thing it kind of sucks on is curse resistance because it has none. But it's still a really cool armor set. I might wear it. I mean, oh yeah, the Silver Knight armor set can be reinforced, but you need Twinkling Titanite to do it. But yeah, let me see. Yeah, this stuff is really heavy though. 6.3, 16.4. Yeah. You're looking at least 30 pounds here, if that. It's heavy.
Tis no good, but forge, very good. I have any time. Talk, tis no good. No one home, everyone gone. But you, friend, you talk. I no talk, but happy. But you, I, but happy.
Alright, that's all he says.
Come back soon.
I love this guy so much. It really disappoints me when I find his corpse in Dark Souls 3. But anyway. So, that's it for now. In the next episode, we will make the attempt to defeat Ornstein and Smough. I've been regretting this. I mean, I've been loathing this for a while. But anyway, enough of my prattling. Until next time, though, this is MegaWizard79, bidding you all adieu.